most már följárát, visszamondtam a jelentőséget.
Thank you for this wonderful introduction. And for the Toastmasters and friends, let's have a candid show of hands. How many of us present here have had at least one problem in our entire lives? Can we have a show of hands? Almost everyone, right? And how many of us present here have had a really tough time in getting out of a problem? What if I told you that in order to get out of a problem, all you need is a key? Sounds fun, right? Good evening to the Toastmasters and distinguished guests. 2 months ago, it was a normal Wednesday morning for me. After handling all the crowd rush in a public sector bank on Monday and Tuesday, I expected it to be a stress-free working day. But all those thoughts went flying out of the window as I was entrusted the responsibility to handle a bunch of keys. Yes, a bunch of 10 keys without which the entire operation of a bank would shut down. You see, inside each and every branch of each and every bank, there lies a safety vault which is used solely for the purpose of deposit of currency notes. That vault may only be opened with the correct combination of not one, not two, but 6 keys of different shapes and sizes. Moreover, that vault is placed inside a room which again is guarded by a shutter. You need to open 4 locks just to get inside the room so that you can access the vault. When you are a banker and you are in possession of the keys, it means that you must be present in your office each and every day, even when it is located at the highway to hell. But then, the key in charge of our office wanted to take a break after a very, very long time. And so, there were no other option for me other than to step up and enter hell. The next day, I arrived at my office well on time, as I assumed the easiest part of the responsibility would be to open all the locks and access the vault. And with that in mind, I bent down and tried to unlock the shutter. No result. I tried once again. No result. This was supposed to be the easiest part. I wondered inside my mind as I tried for the next 5 times. No result whatsoever. That day, it took me 45 minutes to get the entire operation started, which is normally done in a time period of 10 minutes. In the process, I had to take the help of several other staff members. By the end of that day, I lost more hairs from my head than what I normally do on a monthly basis. But then, even though the first day was overwhelming, I was able to take control the day after, and everything was smooth. In fact, after opening every lock expertly on the second day, I was sure that I could open any lock in this entire universe. On the day after, I handed over the keys to my colleague and everything returned to normal. About a month later, my ego was shattered. There is an old cupboard in my house which contains all the worldly possessions of my grandmother. One day, it had to be opened after a very long time. I was high on confidence that I located the key, inserted it into the hole, and twisted my arm in the right direction. No result. I rotated my arm once again. No result. What is going on? I wondered in my mind as I tried for the next 5 times. No result whatsoever. After all my family members were unable to open the lock, obviously, we were convinced that the cupboard was damaged. And so the local carpenter was summoned. Upon arriving, the first thing he did was to stare intently at the lock for about 9 seconds before inserting the key into the hole. About a fraction of a second later, the cupboard opened wide, and so did our mouths. All we had to do was to insert a key in a straight manner. Instead, we were using blunt force. Robbers are like locks. And solving a problem is no different than opening a lock. In both the cases, all we need is a key. Sometimes it takes only one key, whereas sometimes it takes a combination of different keys. In the end, what matters is whether we have the right combination or not. Imagine what would happen if you tried to unlock a car door using a bike key. Imagine what would happen if you tried to unlock a safety vault using a door key. But more often than not, this is what exactly happens when we try to solve a problem. Sometimes the solution, or rather the key, is right in front of us. But we go looking for it in all the unworldly places. Sometimes, in spite of having the right key in our hands, we fail to utilize it properly. Like what happened to me while trying to open the cupboard. Sometimes we end up using the wrong kind of key altogether. Like what happened to me in the bank. Today, in this universe, every lock can be opened. And similarly, in this universe, every problem can be solved, provided we have the right combination. So the next time, whenever you're having a challenge with a problem, don't just perish. Instead, cherish the challenge, and then, before you know it, you will have the key to it, and you will flourish while trying to solve that problem. Best of luck, and thank you.